Today we're out fishing for white sturgeon. We've caught a medium-sized fish that it would be safe to bring inboard. That's less than 60 inches. And so we're gonna demonstrate proper handling technique to get this fish on board safely, uninjured, so we can look at it, take some pictures, and get it back in the water. When possible, we recommend using a sling like this. It's a rubberized net, protects their skin, their scutes. It makes it easier to bring them on board without injuring them. Sturgeon are very large, heavy fish, and when they're not supported by water, that gravity can, the force of gravity can really make them susceptible to internal injuries and wounds, and we don't want that. We want to get them back in the water happy and healthy and safe and ready to be caught again in the future. So we'll get the sling in the water and we'll walk this fish into it. There we go. So we've got this fish in the sling. It's protected, it's supported from gravity. We can now get it down on the deck. Get a measurement, pose for pictures. We want to be careful. We try to use gloves at all times when we can. The slime coat on a fish is part of its immune system. It protects it from disease and allows it to heal. And so we don't want to wipe that off with rags or towels. A nice wet glove is a great way to handle them. We're gonna get a length. We measure it to the fork length, the notch of the tail. It's the most reliable measurement we can get. It doesn't change as much over time. There's 125 centimeters. A large fish like a sturgeon, we can roll it. They may kick, so make sure you have control over the tail. You should be using barbless hooks, so they should come out nice and easy. Make sure they're not tangled in the line. And roll it back. Now to pick up a sturgeon, we don't want to hang it by its tail. We don't want to hang it by its mouth or by its gills. Those are all very sensitive spots and they can lead to injury. We want to support it vertically and support the weight of the sturgeon underneath it. So a good grip on the tail and a hand underneath kind of the center of mass. We can lift it up, we can pose for our photos, and then we'll put it back in the water. Now we don't want to spend too much time doing this. The less time they're out of water, the better. So if you can handle them, land them, unhook them, take a picture and get them back in the water in a couple of minutes, everything's going to be great. It's good for the fish too. So and get this in the water. I'm going to try and hang on to it and let it recover. Just give it a second, and if you get a little shake, it should start to kick off on its own. And there it swims away, happy and healthy. So for that last fish, we use this sling. This has got a nice rubberized mesh. This is a great way to bring a fish into the boat. One or two people can haul it in, supports the fish's weight. It's a great tool to have. But if you don't have that, a large sturgeon net is also a good tool to use. It can protect the fish. It's got to be careful that the fins and stuff don't get torn up by the mesh. If it's a large fish, less than 60 inches, but you still want to bring it onto the boat, you can always use two people to help control the fish more safely so neither you nor the fish get injured. If you don't have the tools to land a fish safely for you or for the fish, you don't have to. You can bring it along to the side of the boat, take pictures, and release it right there. After you've caught your sturgeon, don't forget to fill out your sturgeon report card, which is required. We need information such as the date, the location, size of the fish, and the species. And we use this information to manage the fishery.